Chapter 881, Furious Battle. Just from looking at this other party's aura, they were absolutely a terrifying opponent. If Lin Ming hadn't been discovered, then he would have chosen to hide away, but now that this other party's divine sense had locked onto him, there was simply no place to run away to. As he looked at Old Man Good Fortune, Lin Ming could see that his eyebrows were tightly wrinkled together. It was apparent that he didn't have much assurance against this opponent. It shouldn't be someone from the Sky Spill Continent. There are no powerhouses of this level within the Sky Spill Continent, Old Man Good Fortune said with a solemn expression. Although he came from the Divine Realm and could be called the Warden of this world, the truth was that he really didn't have much to do with the Divine Realm anymore. The reason he came to this Temple of Marvels was to seek his own lucky chances. Against this mysterious existence within the Temple of Marvels, his Divine Realm background could not be used, and even if it could, it wouldn't have worked anyway. Lin Ming and Old Man Good Fortune left the underground mine tunnel together. As they emerged, they saw that the originally dreamy, picturesque blue sky was now awash with billowing dark clouds and sparkling thunder. With a loud bang, a blood-red light perforated the vault of heaven, making it seem as if the sky was being torn apart. A bronze ghost coffin appeared in the skies, and above this coffin were six thick chains, each one held by demon-faced Azure Spirit. As Lin Ming saw this, his complexion completely changed. It looks like the unexpected events from the 8,000-mile Black Swamp were truly related to the Temple of Marvels. Could it be that the entire Temple of Marvels was itself a trap? Lin Ming's mind raced and he quickly retold a scene he saw in the 8,000-mile Black Swamp to Old Man Good Fortune with a true essence sound transmission. However, this was simply useless. Old Man Good Fortune just didn't know what the true connection was between the Sea of Miracles and the Eternal Demon Abyss. It was impossible for him to draw up any useful information from Lin Ming's description. Those six black evil spirits that are drawing the coffin are six refined Azura ghost slaves. Those six ghost slaves each have a quasi-emperor level strength. After being tempered for such a long time, their bodies are nearly indestructible, and with their strength combined together they are even stronger. This sort of Azura ghost slave is countless times more difficult and precious than those slaughter puppets that the Azura Divine Kingdom created. This is certainly not something that belongs to the inheritances of the Sky Spill Continent. And the material of a bronze ghost coffin is a top-quality heavenly metal, grade-resisting profound bronze. It can even be used to produce a quasi-saint artifact treasure. It's impossible to gather this much of that material even in all the mines of the Sky Spill Continent combined. Little friend Lin, we are in deep trouble this time. Within the Sky Spill Continent, there was only a very small number of saint artifacts and quasi-saint artifacts. Nearly all of them were left over from ancient times 100,000 years ago. Even Lin Ming's Great Desolate Blood Halberd and Cosmic Melting Furnace were both found by the Demon Emperor in ancient ruins from 100,000 years past, finally ending up in Lin Ming's hands in the current era. It was nearly impossible for the Sky Spill Continent to create saint artifacts and quasi-saint artifacts. One reason was that there weren't the necessary materials, and a second reason was that there weren't the legacy forging skills required. Bang bang bang. The ghost coffin shook and the entire dimensional realm seemed to tremble. As the chain struck the bronze coffin, it emitted a deafening clanging sound. Old Man Good Fortune's face was grim. He extracted a 4-foot-long sword from his spatial ring. He already had a foreboding feeling that this battle would be difficult. Kaka. A bloody thunder crashed down from the skies and a ghost coffin opened. A slender figure appeared from within the dazzling light. This was the strange and pale demon youth. He held a roar lance in his hands as he slowly descended to the earth from the ghost coffin. As he walked on the ground, the lance point furrowed the earth, the scratches seeming as if they could cut through the will of all, giving people an uncomfortable feeling that they couldn't identify. The time for the great hunt has come. The pale youth said with a thoughtful smile. Although he looked around 20-some years old, his voice seemed old and decrepit, tinted with the flavor of years. Who are you? Old Man Good Fortune stretched out his sword. As the sword tip touched the ground, space seemed to swirl around the sword blade, even twisting the cold light that emitted from the sword. Old Man Good Fortune was completely unable to see the cultivation of this pale youth in front of him. Moreover, this pale youth hadn't bothered to hide it. That only meant there were two possibilities. This pale demon youth's cultivation system was different from that of humanity, or he was a powerhouse above the Divine Sea Realm. Old Man, I advise you not to waste your effort. Although you don't have much time left over, your cultivation is still decent for this trash continent. There still might be some uses in keeping you around. As the pale youth spoke, his figure suddenly stormed forwards. The purple lance in his hands pointed forwards and endless starlight seemed to flow out from his lance point. As his lance thrust out, it made one feel as if they were facing the endless universe. Lin Ming's hands and feet went icy cold and he felt as if his soul had frozen. If just the pressure from this lance was so horrifying, then how terrifying would it be to directly face this? Old Man Good Fortune's expression was grim. He took a step back, seeming as if he were rewinding. The flow of time seemed to twist around his sword. As he slashed out, his strike carried with it the feeling of the years. The brilliant sword light that followed seemed as if it had come from the nothingness of ancient times. Wherever it went, plants would rapidly grow and blossom, die, and bloom once again. Concept of time, glory and withering of years. The pale youth's lance light intensely collided with Old Man Good Fortune's time-breaking sword light. However, there was no sound or light from the collision. Instead, it seemed as if everything was being annihilated into infinite nihility. Although there wasn't the terrifying explosion that was anticipated, this annihilating energy was even more terrifying. All light and material around this collision seemed to disappear, as if it never existed at all. In that moment, Lin Ming stepped on golden rock, shattering the void, and quickly retreated. As Lin Ming turned his head, he saw that the ghostly, Black-dressed Yama had grasped the chain, and without any expression on their faces, had pulled it over Lin Ming. These were the evil spirits that pulled the coffin. Lin Ming's pupils contracted. With a sudden flick, the red spear in his hand swapped to the several hundred thousand Jin Grave Desolate Blood Halberd. These six coffin-pulling evil spirits all had strength equal to a quasi-emperor-level martial artist. If it were Lin Ming from a year ago, who had just crossed life destruction, then it would have been impossible to defeat him. But now his strength had increased and he had also obtained the Great Desolate Blood Halberd. With halberd in hand, he was a god-slaughtering demon. Gate of Pain, open. Lin Ming shouted out, the energy in his body revolving to the limit. The first four gates of the eight inner hidden gates suddenly opened together and 2 million jins of strength completely burst out in the blink of an eye. A blinding divine light shined out from both of his hands, and two black energy devouring vortexes appeared above his palms. This was exactly where the Gate of Pain was located. Lin Ming grasped the halberd in both hands and steadied his waist. His spine drew backwards like a stretched bow as a great force concentrated up his legs and waist. The several hundred thousand Jin Grave Desolate Blood Halberd cut through a perfect arc as it smashed downwards. Bang! The Great Desolate Blood Halberd pounded into the chains, emitting a deafening bang as space collapsed and the earth caved apart. The 20-foot-tall ghost slave and the chain it carried were actually swatted backwards by Lin Ming's halberd. But at the same time, the other five ghost slaves rushed up together. They held chains in their hands, and these chains were also the same material of the ghost coffin, great resisting profound bronze. Lin Ming had smashed away a single ghost slave, but it was impossible for him to simultaneously strike away five ghost slaves. In this critical life or death moment, Lin Ming exploded with potential that surpassed his limits. Holding the halberd in one hand, he drew a crescent moon in the void. The power of space gathered on the Great Desolate Blood Halberd, forming a space storm. Great, countless cracks began to appear in space, as if a black mirror had been shattered. Law of Annihilation, Chain of Stars. A halberd struck out. The power of space condensed into fragments, each filled with the power of a silver battle spirit. As it combined with the howling annihilating flames, this destructive attack fired towards the five ghost slaves. This was the first time Lin Ming had used the Great Desolate Blood Halberd to display a martial skill. Before now he hadn't, because using the Great Desolate Blood Halberd consumed a great deal of energy. If he were to use a martial skill on top of this, then that would create an immense burden on his body. As for Si Chiao, even she had only driven the movement of the Great Desolate Blood Halberd, only using its weight to fight Lin Ming. But now in Lin Ming's hands, with his great 2 million jin strength and his second stage life destruction cultivation, he was finally able to use a martial skill with the Great Desolate Blood Halberd. Pang 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 pang. A series of metallic ringing sounds filled the skies, as if flying swords were striking against great copper bells. The five temperate Azura ghost slaves had bodies as tough as divine metal. The space fragments exploded in succession as they slammed into their bodies. This was the superiority of these ghost slave puppets. It was impossible for a flesh and blood being, no matter how they trained, to have such a terrifying defensive power. Let me see just how tough you are. Lin Ming's eyes turned blood red. Not only did he have the space fragment attack of Chain of Stars, but there was also the Great Desolate Blood Halberd itself. He took a sudden step forwards as the Great Desolate Blood Halberd thundered forwards. A cold, bloody light directly impacted into the skies, illuminating the stars. Ha! With a loud shout, and with the support of a martial skill, the silver battle spirit infused Great Desolate Blood Halberd smashed into the chest of a ghost slave. Just freely dropping the Great Desolate Blood Halberd could shatter a mountain ridge. With Lin Ming's enormous strength behind it, the power of this strike could be imagined. Bang! Like a meteor crashing into the ground, a terrifying explosive sound resounded throughout the entire world. The ghost slave's chest collapsed after being pounded by Lin Ming's halberd, all of its organs bursting apart. Its body hurtled backwards, instantly sent back hundreds of miles before colliding into a far-off mountain peak in the dimensional realm. After that, the entire mountain peak collapsed into a rumbling avalanche. Bang bang bang. Countless massive stones plummeted to the ground. That ghost slave had been miserably smashed to death by Lin Ming's halberd. After the strike, Lin Ming's arm was still shaking. The glorious light emitting from the Gate of Pain on his palms flickered. It was obvious he had consumed a great deal of energy just now. One reason was that using a martial skill with the Great Desolate Blood Halberd required a massive amount of energy. But, the second and more important reason was that the Great Desolate Blood Halberd was not like the long spear that he had been using. It had no flexibility. With every strike he made, he would have to withstand a terrible counter-shaking strength without any buffer. This was also the reason why CGAO was shaken to the point of vomiting blood after exchanging several dozen strikes with Lin Ming. Now, even though Lin Ming had opened the first four of the eight inner hidden gates, and his strength was as powerful as a dragon with 2 million jins of strength, it was still hard for him to withstand the shock of smashing the halberd against this Azura puppet's body, which was like a massive lump of divine metal. The web of his palm was near the point of cracking apart. At this moment, Old Man Good Fortune's true essence sound transmission suddenly sounded out in his ears. Little friend Lin, you leave. Old me can barely defend myself as it is. There is no way I can protect you. Lin Ming looked up and saw that Old Man Good Fortune and that strange ghostly green youth had already flown 10,000 feet in the air, engaged in a vicious battle. Every strike of that strange youth's bird starlight, but every move from Old Man Good Fortune shattered the void. Facing such a level of existence, Lin Ming knew that he would only be a burden if he remained. On the other hand, if he ran away then Old Man Good Fortune would be able to have fewer scruples.